Prepare for launch in 3, 2.
Show what you did wrong. Perfect. Yeah, and so the materials you need are. So, your holder of all of these is the casing yawn. So, first thing you need to do is to unscrew the side panel,
which unfortunately we kind of already did,
and remove them for now. Alright, after that, you need to install the stands that hold up the motherboard.
So, once you got the stalls and stands, you have the motherboard. Unfortunately for us, we don't really have much of any stands. So, just add it.
Hey.
Okay, so you got the motherboard in, and once you got that, you gotta put in the processor. Unfortunately, as you can see here, we already got the processor with the fan in it. So, however, we can still tell you how to put it in. So, we use Thermopaste for this. Put it in, well, that's what we use, so yeah, you could use it. You can get some, use it. So, you put it in, and make sure you have a thin layer on it. If you don't have a thin layer, it's just gonna get thick, and you can't put it on there correctly. Okay, so, the graphics card is in place here. So, what you gotta do is make sure you push it in tight enough so it won't budge, and make sure you are able to clip it on here. And if you're able to do that and keep this thing in place, you should be fine. Okay, so, graphics card's in. That means you're gonna need the RAM, which is this little piece of strip of plastic. So make sure you don't touch the bronze parts, and unfortunately, it could possibly fry it.
After putting in the RAM, that would be a great time to put in the fans.
Yeah, both in the front and back to alternate, so both the heating would go, cool air would go in, heat it would go out, so your heater won't overheat and die. Okay, so on the fans here, you should be able to see some arrows, which should be pointing where the fan is blowing towards. So, unfortunately, you cannot see it here, but right here, the arrow's pointing this way and the arrow's pointing that way. So, what we want to do is we want to put it like this, for the fact that it's blowing out this way. Okay, you got the fans in now, cool it down, so the next thing you need to install is the hard drive. So, hard drive, of course, stores all your stuff. What you do is you take this front part off, and what you do is you insert it through here, and just taking it off would make it easier. Put it through here, screw it in. However, ours locks in place, so we don't really need to screw it in. Put it in. That's pretty much it for the hard drive. Okay, so we got the CD writer here, which is one of the last things we gotta do at the end before we connect the wires or anything. So, what we do is you just remove the front panel here. Okay, so once you got everything else in there, it's time to put in the wires, which is actually really simple since most of them are, you know, already tied up, and you can just simply put them in like so. Or like others where these are individual and you have to put them in. Okay, so you got the wires all cleaned up and everything. All you gotta do now is just simply put it back in, and you're done. All software. There you go.
Say that for bloopers.
Testing. 1, 2, 3. Testing!
Okay.
Are you recording?
I hate you all.
After that, you just screw in the fan, lock it in place, and you're pretty much good.
Okay,
to go.
Okay, so
you stop it. You touch it, I push it straight.
Okay.
So, bring it in.
What?
Far enough to where it's equal right here. You just screw it in.
Pause it.
Pause it.
Pause it.
No.
Stop recording.